I just loved trying to come up with these stories that could, you know, move people in a way that I wanted. And it's something I definitely haven't lost my passion for, even though I've stepped into the agricultural side of things. I'm an agribusiness analyst with National Australia Bank. So I grew up on a farm. I'm the sixth generation to be on that farm. My grandparents' era were probably the last ones to be your stereotypical definition of a farmer. The modern day farmer, those people have to be CEOs and CFOs and vets and agronomists and risk analysts. And they're not simply farmers anymore. They are scientists and business people that think ahead of their field all the time because they have to adapt. A lot of what I do at work now involves numbers, and the only way you can really work through figures like that is to work logically through them. But I think where the creativity side comes into things like finance is the way you discuss financials and these different elements of business with customers. What's the best way to then convey our decisions and our requirements to the customer in a way that's respectful for them, shows our knowledge of the business and ensures that they feel like they're being supported. I entered arts and I loved testing myself, but what I felt the whole way through is that there was something missing. And so when my arts degree finished, looking into myself to an extent, I just thought, well, it's agriculture. I've been taught to think, really, by the Melbourne Model, and that is to use bits of knowledge and bits of understanding from all these different fields to come to this central idea, I suppose, of how to think and how to approach a problem. I'm an agricultural scientist who thinks beyond the field.